हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई होप यू ऑल आर वेल। वेलकम टू योर फोर्थ लेक्चर ऑफ हेलोजन डेरिवेटिव्स। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद एन इम्पॉर्टेंट एंड इंटरेस्टिंग टॉपिक, ऑप्टिकल आइसोमेरिज्म इन हेलोजन डेरिवेटिव्स। वी ऑल हैव आर फेमिलियर विद द वर्ड आइसोमेरिज्म। वट इज आइसोमेरिज्म? आइसोमेरिज्म इज वॉट अ फेनोमिना बाय विच अ कंपाउंड में different compounds will show you same molecular formula but they will exhibit different chemical properties or chemical structures. So compounds that have identical chemical formulae but differ in properties and the arrangement of atoms in the molecules are called isomers. Isomers can be broadly divided into two main categories: structural isomerism, or second one is stereoisomerism. We have studied in your class 11 about structural isomerism, where we have discussed different types of structural isomerism. For example, functional group isomerism, tautomerism, metamerism, chain isomerism, position isomerism. These were what? The isomerism which was based on difference in the structure of the molecules which were having the same molecular formula. The other important type of isomerism is stereoisomerism. What is stereoisomerism? Stereoisomerism is a phenomena where you will find that the molecules will have same molecular formula, same sequence of linking of atoms, that is same connectivity, but differ in their structures due to different orientation in space. Okay, so in stereoisomerism, the basic is that the connectivity of all the atoms or group of atoms are same. Molecular formula is obviously same, but how the molecules arranged itself in the three-dimensional space or three-dimensional world, that determines their property, and such kind of isomerism is known as stereoisomerism. Now, let's see what is stereoisomerism more nicely. Look, stereoisomers can be of two types: geometric isomers and optical isomers. What is geometric isomerism? We have discussed that in your class 11th as cis-trans isomerism. Here you can see one example. If the same kind of group of atoms are on the same side of the double bond, we'll say it is cis isomer. And if they are arranged or attached on the opposite side of the double bond, they are termed as trans isomer. This is also a kind of stereoisomer because the formula is same, everything is same. The only difference is due to the spatial arrangement of these atoms across the double bond. Here you should know that geometric isomerism is observed only in case of such molecules which have restricted rotation of atoms. For example, in alkene, wherever is the double bond, that double bond restricts the rotation of atoms around it, and the atoms which are attached to these atoms acquires the fixed position, okay, due to which the cis and trans atoms or molecules come into existence. Now today's main importance we will give to the optical isomerism. In optical isomerism, what happens? You will find that some of the molecules of the organic compound show reactivity towards light. Optical means light, okay? So these are the molecules which shows different reactivity towards the light, okay? Depending upon their reactivity towards the light, the optical isomers are divided into plus isomer and minus isomer. And these optical isomers always exist as a pair of isomers, okay? One of the pair of the isomer will be termed as positive enantiomer and the another is negative. So the pair of optical isomers are termed as enantiomer. Let's see main why they are termed like this and what is the reason why do they show optical activity. That we'll discuss later. Let's see one example is here. Here you have been given the example of lactic acid. What is lactic acid? Lactic acid is COOH, CH2 and lactic acid is CH3, COOH, COOH. This is your lactic acid. Here three-dimensional structure of lactic acid is given. Okay. And these are what? ऑप्टिकल आइसोमर्स. व्हाई दे आर ऑप्टिकल आइसोमर्स, लेट्स फाइंड इट आउट. ओके, फॉर अंडरस्टैंडिंग द ऑप्टिकल आइसोमेरिज्म वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड फ्यू थिंग्स फर्स्ट. ओके, ऑप्टिकल आइसोमेरिज्म इज वॉट द आइसोमेरिज्म दैट इज ड्यू टू द रिएक्टिविटी टूवर्ड्स दी लाइट. नाउ फर्स्ट अंडरस्टैंड वॉट इज लाइट. लाइट इज एन इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक रेडिएशन. ओके, वी नो इट. सो लाइट प्रोपोगेट इन वन डायरेक्शन एंड इट्स इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक रेडिएशन वाइब्रेट इन परपेंडिकुलर प्लेन टू द डायरेक्शन ऑफ प्रोपोगेशन ऑफ लाइट. सपोज योर लाइट इज पासिंग और हैविंग द डायरेक्शन ऑफ प्रोपोगेशन दिस. सो इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक रेडिएशन वाइब्रेट परपेंडिकुलर टू द प्लेन ऑफ डायरेक्शन ऑफ प्रोपोगेशन ऑफ लाइट. ओके, नाउ व्हेन लाइट पासेस द लाइट पार्टिकल्स वाइब्रेट और द लाइट वाइब्रेट और ऑसिलेट इन ऑल द पॉसिबल प्लेन्स परपेंडिकुलर टू द प्लेन ऑफ प्रोपोगेशन ऑफ लाइट. ओके, सो दिस इज माई डायरेक्शन ऑफ प्रोपोगेशन ऑफ लाइट एंड द लाइट विल ऑसिलेट इन ऑल पॉसिबल डायरेक्शंस दैट इज परपेंडिक्युलर टू द एक्सिस ऑफ प्रोपोगेशन. ओके, सो इट इज वाइब्रेटिंग इन ऑल पॉसिबल प्लेन परपेंडिक्युलर टू द डायरेक्शन ऑफ प्रोपोगेशन ऑफ लाइट. दिस इज योर ऑर्डिनरी लाइट कंसिस्टिंग ऑफ ऑल कलर वेवलेंथ. ओके, नाउ व्हेन दिस ऑर्डिनरी लाइट इज पास थ्रू अ पोलराइजर, ओके, व्हाट हैपेंस? ऑल द ऑसिलेटिंग वाइब्रेटिंग लाइट्स गेट फिल्टर्ड ऑफ एंड द लाइट दैट विल कम आउट ऑफ द पोलराइजर विल कंसिस्ट ऑफ द लाइट विच इज ओनली वाइब्रेटिंग और ऑसिलेटिंग इन वन प्लेन. दैट प्लेन वुड बी परपेंडिकुलर टू द प्लेन ऑफ प्रोपोगेशन ऑफ डायरेक्शन ऑफ प्रोपोगेशन ऑफ लाइट. लेट सी हाउ इट इज डन. देर इज अ लाइट सोर्स विच कंसिस्ट ऑफ द लाइट विच इज लाइट वेव विच इज ऑसिलेटिंग इन ऑल द पॉसिबल डायरेक्शन परपेंडिक्युलर टू द योर direction of propagation of light. Now this light is passed through a, this is called as, can be called as unpolarized light. It is passed through a polarizer. What is polarizer? It is generally a Nicole prism. We'll take polarizer as Nicole prism. Okay. Now what does this Nicole prism do? It will change this or it will filter off all the plane of oscillation of the light and the light that will come out of this will now only vibrate in single plane. So from lot of oscillating vibrating lights we'll get a light which is oscillating in only one direction, one plane, and we'll term it as plane polarized light. So the light passes through the polarizer, which is generally a Nicole prism, and come out of polarizer in the form of polarized light, and that light is termed as plane polarized light. Now this plane polarized light is passes through a polarimeter that contains your sample whose optical activity you want to determine. Okay, now the sample is in polarimeter. When this plane polarized light passes through this sample cell, if the compound or the molecule which is present in the sample cell have reactivity towards the light, it will shift the direction or it will rotate the plane of polarized light either to the left or to the right. So if you analyze this sample through the analyzer and you come to know that the plane of polarized light has rotated to some angle towards the right or towards the left, you would say the compound is optically active. And if the sample does not react with the light and comes same to same, come out same to same from the polarimeter without rotating the plane of polarized light, we'll say the sample is optically inactive. This is how we determine the optical activity of compounds. Okay. I hope you have understood what is plane polarized light, a beam of light which consists of the waves of light vibrating in one plane. Now we don't get this plane polarized light automatically. We have to obtain it by passing the plain or ordinary light through a polarizer, or you can say Nicole's prism. Okay. Now, what is optical activity? Now, can you tell what is optical activity? Now, the optical activity is what? When plain polarized light is passed through a solution of certain organic substances, the plane of polarized light gets rotated through certain angle. This property of the solution to rotate the PPL towards left or right is known as optical activity. Okay, so only those compounds which are able to do this, which can rotate the plane of polarized light through same angle towards the left or right, are called optically active substances, and other are optically inactive. Another important thing I want you to note down here is the compounds which rotate the plane of polarized light towards the left-hand side would be termed as levorotatory, and that which rotate it towards the right-hand side would be termed as dextrorotatory. Now, the compound which are rotating the plane of polarized light towards right are dextrorotatory, and they would be indicated by the symbol plus or D before their name. And if they rotate it towards left, they will be termed as levorotatory, and they will be indicated by the negative sign or L before their name in the structure, in the formulae. Now, remember one thing: by no method we can determine whether the compound is dextrorotatory or levorotatory just by looking at the structure of the molecule. So it has to be determined through experiment only ki the compound is dextro or levorotatory. Okay, now one more thing I wanted to emphasize here: what difference will it make whether it is dextrorotatory or levorotatory, or whether it is optically active or not? Okay, I wanted to give you one example here. Now look at these two examples. They are optical isomers of each other. Okay, the name of one molecule is Dirone and the another one is Noad. Both of them have exactly same structure and same molecular formula, you can see. The only difference between them is what? If I place a mirror here, you will find that this image or this molecule is the mirror image of this molecule. So these two are what are appearing to be the mirror images of each other, and nothing else is different about them. This is what is appearing to us. But one more thing I want to show here is that this molecule benzene is what? Having a bond with this carbon, and have shown a wedge here, which means that this is the molecule which is attached out of the paper or towards our cell. And this is the benzene molecule which is attached with this carbon. And this is shown by a dash bond. This bonding is shown by a dash bond, which indicates that the benzene is away from us behind the paper, below the paper. Okay, so only this difference in the structure of this molecule, not in the structure of this molecule, in the arrangement of atoms or molecule or group of atom in the space resulted in the two isomers. Okay, now this Dirone is used as a painkiller, whereas Noad is an anti-cough reagent. Okay, so optical isomers are of great importance because different optical isomers have different effect on our body or on wherever they are being used. Okay, the phenomenon of optical activity was discovered in 1815, but why some molecules show optical activity was not clear until that time. Okay, the relation between the optically active substance with its structure was determined by Van't Hoff and Liebel in 1874. They come up with the theory of optical theory. With the help of that optical theory, by looking at the structure of the molecule, we can identify whether the molecule will exhibit optical activity or not. They said that the carbon atom which is present in the organic molecule which are showing optical activity have tetrahedral geometry. In this tetrahedral structure, the central carbon atom is bonded to four other atoms or group of atoms. The bond which I have shown with the normal line are supposed to be the lines or the atoms which are present on the plane of paper. The dark wedge which is shown here is the bond which is coming out of the paper towards ourselves. Okay, so it is above the paper, and the bond which I have shown with the dash is the bond which is going below this paper away from ourselves. Okay, so if we want to present a tetrahedral structure on a two-dimensional paper, we have to keep in mind that the two bonds of that carbon atom lies on the plane of paper, and the remaining two bonds are not on the paper. One is above the paper, which can be shown by a wedge, and one is below the paper, which can be shown by a dash. Okay, now in this tetrahedral structure, if this carbon is bonded to four different atoms, we'll say that this is a chiral carbon or a symmetric carbon, and it should be indicated by asterisk mark on that carbon. Okay, so the carbon atom that is bonded to four different atoms or group of atoms is termed as chiral carbon, Chiral, chiral carbon or asymmetric carbon represented by asterisk mark on this carbon. They found that only those molecule which contains this kind of carbon, chiral carbon, can exhibit optical activity. If they do not have chiral carbon, they will not show optical activity. Okay, so asymmetric carbon atom is a tetrahedral carbon which is bonded to four different atoms or group is your chiral carbon atom. Okay, so any molecule which contains asymmetric carbon atom will exist as a pair of isomer. That pair of isomer would be mirror image of each other. Okay, and these two mirror images will be the non-superimposable mirror images. Now, what is mean by that? Take this example. Here, this is one tetrahedral chiral carbon, okay, which is bonded to four different atoms. And here also I have its mirror image, that is why it is its isomer. So they are existing as a pair of isomer, but they are non-superimposable mirror images. What is mean by non-superimposable mirror images? If I remove this atom molecule and I'll try to keep it on exactly on this molecule, you will find that they are not covering or overlapping each other properly. You will find that this molecule will overlap on this gray atom, and this gray atom will come on this purple atom. Okay, so they will not overlap each other. Such images or such isomers are called as non-superimposable isomers or images. And only these non-superimposable molecules are able to rotate the plane of polarized light towards left or towards right. Now, out of these two isomers, one will be dextrorotatory and the other will be levorotatory. It means one will rotate the PPL towards the left-hand side by some angle X, let's say, and the other will rotate it towards the right-hand side by the same angle. Okay, so their angle of rotation alpha will remain same, but one will rotate it towards the left and the other will rotate it towards the right. Okay, so one is your dextrorotatory or positive isomer, and the another one is levorotatory or negative isomer. Their IUPAC name will remain same. To understand which isomer it is, they will be indicated by the sign D or positive or minus or negative before their name. So you can also take the example of your hand. Our hands are exactly mirror images of each other. Okay, if I put a mirror here, I will get an image which will be exactly like my this hand. Okay, now if I superimpose my one hand on the other hand, they are not going to cover each other properly. Okay, so if I want to create this isomer, exactly this isomer, what should I do? आई कैन डू इट ओनली बाय कटिंग माई वन ऑफ द थंब एंड पुट फिक्सिंग इट ऑन दी अदर साइड एंड कटिंग माई दिस लिटिल फिंगर एंड फिक्सिंग इट ऑन दी अपोजिट साइड. ओके, सो बाय रोटेटिंग अवर मॉलिक्यूल वी कैन नॉट ऑब्टेन द सेम स्ट्रक्चर. वी कैन नॉट ऑब्टेन दिस स्ट्रक्चर बाय रोटेटिंग दिस स्ट्रक्चर थ्रू 180 डिग्री. लुक, आई एम रोटेटिंग माई वन हैंड बाय 180 डिग्री. नाउ आई कैन ओवरलैप इट, येस, बट माई हैंड साइड हैव चेंज्ड. ओके, सो दे विल नॉट बी द सेम थिंग. ओके, सो आइसोमर्स, वन ऑफ द ऑप्टिकल आइसोमर कैन नॉट बी कन्वर्टेड इन टू द अनदर आइसोमर जस्ट बाय रोटेटिंग इट टू द थ्रू द एंगल ऑफ 180 डिग्री. इट विल रिक्वायर द ब्रेकिंग एंड रीअरेंजमेंट ऑफ बॉन्ड. ओके, सो दिस स्पेशियल अरेंजमेंट विच रिजल्ट्स इन द नॉन सुपर इम्पोजिबल मिरर इमेजेस आर वॉट योर ऑप्टिकल एक्टिविटी. ओके, ओनली सम सच मॉलिक्यूल्स विच कंटेन्स द कायरल कार्बन, वन कायरल कार्बन और मोर देन वन कायरल कार्बन इन इट विल एग्जिबिट यू और विल शो द ऑप्टिकल आइसोमेरिज्म. लेट्स टेक वन एग्जाम्पल. दिस इज लैक्टिक एसिड मॉलिक्यूल. इन लैक्टिक एसिड मॉलिक्यूल्स यू कैन सी देर आर थ्री कार्बन, ऑल दीज ब्लैक एटम्स आर कार्बन एटम. ओके, नाउ लेट्स फाइंड आउट डू वी हैव एनी कायरल कार्बन इन इट और नॉट. दिस इज योर फर्स्ट कार्बन. दिस कार्बन इज बॉन्डेड टू थ्री हाइड्रोजन एटम्स. ओके, सो इट इज बॉन्डेड, नॉट बॉन्डेड टू फोर डिफरेंट एटम्स, दैट्स वाई इट इज नॉट अ कायरल कार्बन. ओके, लेट्स टेक द अपर वन. दिस कार्बन इज बॉन्डेड टू, मेकिंग टू बॉन्ड्स विद दिस ऑक्सीजन एटम, अगेन मेकिंग, नॉट मेकिंग फोर डिफरेंट बॉन्ड विथ फोर डिफरेंट एटम्स और ग्रुप ऑफ एटम, देयर फॉर इट इज ऑल्सो नॉट अ कायरल कार्बन. बट लेट्स सी दिस मिडल कार्बन. दिस मिडल कार्बन इज बॉन्डेड टू हाइड्रोजन ऑन वन साइड, ओ एच ऑन दी अदर साइड, सी एच थ्री बॉन्ड एंड सी ओ ओ एच बॉन्ड. सो दिस कार्बन इज बॉन्डेड टू फोर डिफरेंट कार्बन एटम्स और ग्रुप ऑफ एटम्स, दैट्स वाई इट इज अ कायरल कार्बन. एंड दिस मॉलिक्यूल विल शो वॉट ऑप्टिकल एक्टिविटी. सो प्रेजेंस ऑफ कायरल कार्बन इज ऑफ ग्रेट इम्पोर्टेंस फॉर एग्जिबिटिंग द प्रॉपर्टी ऑफ ऑप्टिकल एक्टिविटी. दिस इज अ थ्री डायमेंशनल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ लैक्टिक एसिड. वी कैन ऑल्सो प्रेजेंट इट ऑन पेपर विद द हेल्प ऑफ फिशर प्रोजेक्शन फॉर्मूला. ओके, दैट इज, वॉट इज योर फिशर प्रोजेक्शन फॉर्मूला? इट इज सी एच ओ एच, सी ओ ओ एच एंड सी एच थ्री. दिस इज योर लैक्टिक एसिड मॉलिक्यूल एंड इट विल एग्जिबिट हाउ मेनी कायरल कार्बन इट कंटेन्स. इट कंटेन्स ओनली वन कायरल कार्बन. सो हाउ मेनी ऑप्टिकल आइसोमर इट विल हैव, वी कैन फाइंड इट बाय द फॉर्मूला 2^2 n. द ऑप्टिकल आइसोमर्स कैन बी डिटरमाइंड बाय द फाइंडिंग आउट हाउ मेनी कायरल कार्बन्स आर प्रेजेंट. इफ योर एन इक्वल्स टू वन, इट मीन्स यू विल हैव ओनली टू ऑप्टिकल आइसोमर्स. एज लैक्टिक एसिड कंटेन्स ओनली वन कायरल कार्बन, ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दिस फॉर्मूला 2^2 n, विल हैव ओनली टू ऑप्टिकल आइसोमर्स ऑफ लैक्टिक एसिड. This is the structure of glucose. Now let's see whether glucose will show optical activity or not. And if it shows optical activity, how many optical isomers are possible for glucose? Now let's try to analyze which carbon atoms are chiral here. Let's look at the first carbon. This is your first carbon. This carbon is bonded to two oxygen atoms. Oh, sorry, making two bonds with oxygen atoms. Therefore, it cannot be a chiral carbon. So this first carbon is not a chiral carbon. Look at this second carbon. Second carbon is making one bond with this hydrogen, one with OH, one this with this CHO group, and the one is with remaining this whole group. Okay. So on all the four bonds are with four different kind of groups. That's why I'll say that this carbon is your chiral carbon. Okay. Now let's analyze this one. This one is also attached to four different atoms and group of atoms, H, OH, this whole group on one side and this entire group on the other side. So this is also a chiral carbon, that is the second, third carbon. This one will also be the chiral carbon, and this one will also be the chiral carbon. Now look at this last carbon atom. The last carbon atom is making two bond with hydrogen. So it is not making four different bonds, therefore it is not a chiral carbon. So glucose is what? Contains how many chiral carbon? Four chiral carbon, or four stereocenters are there. So glucose will present or make optical, show optical isomerism. And how many optical isomers are possible? So according to this formula, it is 2 raised to n, that is 2 raised to how many isomers? Stereocenter 1, 2, 3, 4, that is 2 raised to 4. It would be what? 16 isomers. Glucose will make 16 optical isomers. Look, we can draw Fischer formula, Fischer projection formula, as well as we can draw that wedge and dash formula for showing the enantiomers. In case of Fischer projection formula, remember that the vertical line represents bonds below the paper and horizontal lines represent bonds above the paper. Okay, so vertical line below paper and horizontal line above paper. Okay, in case of Fischer projection formula. Understood? Or in when we are using wedge and dash formula, I have told you how to represent the atom. Understood? Now I hope you have understood the meaning of optical activity, optical isomers, and optical isomers are terms in enantiomers. How do we define the enantiomers? Enantiomers are the non-superimposable mirror images of each other that rotates the plane of polarized light through the same angle but in opposite directions. They are also known as enantiomorphs and optical antipodes. Another important term I want you to know is racemic mixture. Racemates are generally prepared in laboratory. What are racemates? Racemates are prepared by mixing equal concentration of dextrorotatory and levorotatory molecule compounds together. What happens here? When you take equal concentration of dextro and levo molecules, they will cancel the rotation and the net rotation would be zero and they will not show any optical activity. So racemic mixture are what? Equimolar concentration of dextro and levo rotatory molecules. How do we define it? The equimolar quantities of dextro and levo isomers when mixed results in the formation of such an optically inactive compounds which will not rotate the plane of polarized light. Okay, and this would be termed as racemate or racemic mixture. You can write this definition from here. Okay, now remember that naturally dextro and levo rotatory isomer exist, but as a pair, but it is not compulsory that they exist in 50-50% amount. Naturally occurring isomers may exist in different ratio. Okay, but when we prepare them in the laboratory, we prepare generally racemic mixture. Okay, now let's check the comprehension so that we can find out or we can identify the optically active compounds or not. I have taken three examples, three molecules. Number one is your CH3CHOHCH2CH3, that is butane 2-ol. Now let's find out, does it contain any chiral carbon in it? If chiral carbon is present, it will be an optically active compound. So let's look at the first carbon. Your first carbon is CH3, having three hydrogens, three same atoms, so it could not be a chiral carbon. Let's take the second one. The second one is attached to one hydrogen, one OH. At one side it is attached to methyl group and on the other side it is attached to ethyl group. So this carbon is attached to four different types of groups on at the four sides. Therefore, it is a chiral carbon, and this compound will show optical activity. Butane 2-ol is an optically active compound. The next one is pentane 2-ol. Okay, so here the first carbon could not be your chiral carbon because it has 3 hydrogen. This also cannot be a chiral carbon containing 2 hydrogen. Let's take this one. This carbon is attached to hydrogen, one hydroxyl groups, and on one this side it is attached to ethyl group, CH2CH3 group. On this side also it is attached to ethyl group, CH2CH2. It has two same attachment, therefore it is not a chiral carbon, and obviously these two are also not chiral, so this is not a chiral compound. Okay, let's check this one. All the CH3 and CH2 are not chiral because they contain more than one same type of atom. This is also not a chiral carbon. Now let's check this one. This carbon is attached to hydrogen on one side, ethyl on this side, but it is attached to methyl from here and methyl from here also. So it has two same attachment, two methyl groups attached here. So this is also not a chiral molecule. So out of these three examples, only this one is optically active and will show the chiral, will have the chiral compound, form the chiral compound. These are the few examples of chiral molecules. I want you all to draw their structure and its mirror image and try to understand that how optical isomers exist in nature. I am going to show you this one, 2,3 dimethyl pentane. It is 2,3 dimethyl pentane. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is your pentane. It is 2,3 dimethyl pentane. So let's make one methyl group here and let's show one methyl here. Okay. 2,3 dimethyl pentane. Let's find out where is your chiral carbon atom. Okay. This is your CH3 group. Okay. Nothing is here means it is CH3 group. Okay. So this CH3 contains 3 hydrogen, therefore it is not a chiral carbon. This junction is your CH2 group. It contains 2 hydrogen, so it is also not a chiral carbon. This carbon is attached to methyl from one side, that is this one, and this carbon is attached to ethyl from the other side, CH2CH3. Two different things. And on this side, it is attached to CH, CH3, CH3, isopropyl group, okay, and hydrogen. So this would be your chiral carbon. And this is your chiral molecule. If you are having difficulty in understanding in this way, let's make its dash structure, CH3, CH2, CH, CH3, CH, CH3, CH3. This is 2,3 dimethyl pentane. Okay. Now this is your stereo center because it has a carbon which is attached to 4 different types of atoms and group of atoms. So this is your stereo center, chiral carbon. Now let's check whether this is also a chiral carbon or not. So this carbon is attached to hydrogen, CH3 from one side and CH3 also from the other side. So this is not a chiral carbon. So this 2,3 dimethyl pentane will have how many optical isomers? As it has only one chiral center, according to the formula 2^n, it will have only 2 isomers possible. Okay, so you should be able to draw its mirror image also. In the same way, I want you to make 2 chlorobutane and alanine and make its mirror image and try to understand that how optical isomers exist in the two forms. Now, the optical, why I have emphasized so much on optical isomerism, because this optical isomerism helps us in understanding the reaction mechanism. After this, we are going to study about the reactions of alkyl halide and this optical activity of some of the halogen derivative will help us to understand the mechanism of some important reactions. Okay, so let's finish our lecture today here only, and we'll meet in the next lecture, inshallah. Until then, be safe. Allah Hafiz.